All right. Good afternoon, everyone. Yeah, good afternoon, Vinesh. All right, so it was the last topic we discussed on. Yeah, problem, guys. So cryptography, right? So we have a final module, which is web application penetration testing as an introduction. So I'll give an idea about this web application penetration testing and what are the different types of testings we have in this, what are their process, focuses, and the applications they use to perform these penetration testing. We'll discuss on that part. Okay. So first, let me go with the penetration testing. So as I told you, what is this penetration testing? Anyone? Do you have any idea? Yeah. So anyone, what is penetration testing? It is shortened form is pen testing, we call. In shortened, we call this as a pen testing. Right. So anyone having any idea about this? So when we do penetration testing, it's kind of an advanced level of a program in cybersecurity. So if you see in beginning time, beginning of this program, I have given a roadmap for you. Do you remember that? Like, what is cybersecurity? What is ethical hacking in that? And what are the programs we have? Do you remember that part? At the beginning, like I have given a roadmap for you. So actually, cybersecurity is nothing but a domain here. Okay, so cybersecurity means it's a kind of a domain, just a domain, in that we have different programs. Like you have a degree or BTech. A BTech is just a program here, in that you're doing a course called CSE, Civil, Automobile, Electronics, Mechanical. Like these are the programs. Same in that way. Cyber security is a program, in that we have a different program starting with the networking fundamentals to ethical hacking. So why ethical hacking? In the sense, as I told you, it's a core part of cyber security, where it will introduce you to all the programs. Means in ethical hacking, we learned about the malwares, we learned about the system hacking, we learned about the Wi-Fi, we learned about the social engineering, we learned about the firewalls. Like scanning, all these things we have learned. If you observe, like attacks, their methodologies, their tactics, techniques, procedures, like all these things we have learned. Yes or no? Right. So I hope you guys got some idea about the cybersecurity from this program. I hope so. Like, what are the attacks will be there? Like, how we can defend against these attacks? How the hackers perform these techniques to perform a attack on these target organizations. So I hope you got an idea. All right. So in this program, you learned about these core parts of what cybersecurity contains, and then you can move on to any of the team called Red Team or Blue Team. So Red Team is completely an offensive base. Right, and blue team is nothing but completely the defensive side, right? So like offensive in the sense where we are breaking into their systems, finding their vulnerabilities, giving some patch management for them. All these things comes under the offensive part. Defensive is nothing but the blue team, where they'll provide a security for the organization's infrastructures or to their systems or to their networks, and provide some security to that, and monitor 24/7 the activities in their organizations, and go with the incident responses also. So in that, when it comes to the retting, the main program we have is penetration testing. Penetration testing. So it is a kind of a cyber attack on the computer systems, networks, or applications. So it's a controlled and authorized process. Remember, penetration testing is a controlled. It is a controlled and authorized process. What process it is? To identify the vulnerabilities that malicious actor could exploit them, right? So we need to perform that before the attacks happen. So we should not wait until the attack happens here. Before only we have to perform some penetration testing on the target systems, networks, or their applications, and find the loopholes and go for the impact of that loophole and give the patch for that and go with the report writing. So that is what the penetration testing is. Okay. So in penetration testing, again, there are different programs like web application penetration testing, IoT penetration testing, or cloud pen testing, or cloud security, or network penetration testing, or mobile penetration testing, or you can go with the, what you can say, API. Even again in mobile also, we have iOS penetration testing and Android penetration testing. So you can see in penetration testing itself, we have again the advanced level of programs. These are all the programs. You can't go with all of them. Okay, you may do two or three programs, I can say that, but because they are in detail about, like, it will, you need to deep dive into that particular program, and you need to analyze in detail about that particular activities, their functions, their processes, their compliances, everything you need to find there. But my point, so that is what the penetration testing is. So here you're just going with the introduction part in ethical hacking, and after that you can move on either to the red team or blue team. You can do the both also. That is what we call it as a purple team. Call that as a purple team. So it's a combination of red and blue. Okay, that is what the purple team is. He knows, he's good in offensive basis, and he's good in the defensive also. Right. So when it comes to the blue team scenarios, we have programs like SOC, Security Operational Center. I think I have shown you what is that SOC. There is a centralized source where they monitors each and every activities of the organizations. Like you can see, like you have command and control server for the departments. You know that command and control center. So where they monitors each and every activities of the organization. In the cities, and if any incidents happen immediately, they're informed to the nearby stations. Same here also, we have a SOC center where you can see this is the command and control center, right? So, and in, when it comes to the, in real time, they'll monitor real time activities of the organizations. They collect the logs, they analyze the logs, and they correlate the logs, and they look for the incidents, and then they'll give the, they'll inform that incident to the incident response team. They'll check that, and they'll immediately respond for that incident, and they'll provide the security for that incident. That is what they do. So this is completely defensive thing. This is completely like a defensive. That is what SOC. So in that we have SIM solutions. So how we are monitoring them and collecting them in the sense, by using a SIM solution, security incident and event management. Like you may heard about the tools like Splunk or QRadar, IBM QRadar, or Elastic. So these are the sources where you can see for these solutions where to monitor. So SOC is nothing but, so it's a combination of people and the place. It's a place where the people will monitor each and every activities of the organizations by using these SIM solutions. And again, they have many other programs like incident responder or malware analyst or cyber threat intelligent analyst. Like that, there are different programs you can see in this particular program. In this, we have digital forensic. Right. So like that, you have a different teams here. Right. So in that, one of the program is penetration testing. Got my point? Is that clear, everyone? So if you want to move on to this penetration testing, so you need to go through all these internal services. Like if you're going with web application, you should aware of what web applications are. If you're going with IoT, you should aware about the IoT things. If you want to go with the cloud, you need to go with the what is cloud and how the things work. And network pen testing, network, mobile, API, application programming. So it means you have to good in that particular sources, then you can move on to the penetration testing. So penetration testing is a kind of a exercise where a cybersecurity expert attempts to find where they is used to find and exploit the vulnerabilities in a computer system. So the purpose of this simulated attack is to identify the weak spots in a system's defense, which attackers could take the advantage of. So we need to find them before they take the advantage. Okay. So again, in penetration testing, we have different phases, like starting from planning and scoping things. So how this pen testing works in the sense. First, planning. So planning and scoping scenarios. So planning is nothing but here. We need to, before penetrating the defense, which systems, applications, and data will be targeted. So it is crucial to clearly define the boundaries and objectives to ensure a safe and productive test here. So first you need to choose your target. Accordingly, you need to analyze what the things they are maintaining. Accordingly, you need to penetrate into their systems. And in that we have the scoping scenario. So scoping is nothing but what to do and what not to do. So we have a in scope scenario and out scope scenario. So in scope in the sense, these are the things which we need to penetrate, and out scope in the sense, which is not mandatory to do that. Okay. So internally and outsourcing also you can perform them, right? So planning and scoping. So the scope of the pen testing defines which systems, applications, and data will be targeted, and it is crucial to clearly define the boundaries and objectives to ensure a safe and productive test here. And later, you can go with the reconnaissance, as we know, as I told you at the beginning also, reconnaissance and scanning phase is very, very important for you. Whenever or wherever you are planning for the attack, you need to go through the reconnaissance first, then go with the scanning part, right? So reconnaissance, which is nothing but penetration testing, or these pen testers gather the information about the target systems, such as their operating systems, software versions, network configurations, and any kind of attacks they're impacting their systems or not. They need to find that information. So this helps them to understand the attack surface. By performing the reconnaissance, it helps the pen testers to understand the attack surface here. So once you're done with the recon, go with the gaining access. So gaining access is nothing but where penetration means these pen testers simulate the real world attack. So, and they use the real world attack techniques to exploit the vulnerabilities, and even they gain the access to the systems. So these might involve the social engineering tactics also, and even password cracking or even exploiting the software bugs. So there is another phase. And next we have a maintaining access or privilege escalation. So maintaining access and privilege escalation in the sense where once initial the access, you as you know, so previously, if you remember, we have phases of hacking. In that we discussed what are the five phases of hacking in that. So reconnaissance, gaining access, reconnaissance, scanning, gaining access, maintaining access, and clearing logs. Same process we are going to implement in penetration testing also. First, we need to go with the planning. What are the things they are maintaining? Accordingly, we need to look for the scoping thing. And then we need to gather the information, and then we need to gain the access. Then we need to perform the maintenance, means installing some backdoors, whether it is applicable or not. We need to check that, and we need to see what, if it is eligible for the privilege escalation also. You need to perform, means we are checking the impact here. By performing all these things, we are checking the impact of the particular attack, right? And then are they able to cover the tracks or not? We need to check that. And then you can move on to the reporting. So reporting is the final stage. And We call this as a remediation. So means you need to give the like you need to tell them to what to patch there, what kind of things they need to implement, how this attack happened. So because of that particular point, the attack is implementing here. So you need to close that particular thing and you need to go with another version like that. You need to remediate that. So the pen testers document the vulnerability which they discovered and the techniques they used and the potential impact of that vulnerability. They'll describe that in the report. That is what they'll provide to the client. And this report provides a clear picture of the security risk and guides them for the remediation efforts. Okay. So that is what the penetration testers do. So this is what the plan of penetration testers to perform the penetration testing. Is that clear? So what is penetration testing here? We call this as a pen test also. So it is an authorized simulated cyber attack on a computer network or a system or an application. Where they are going to find the attack's information to mitigate them, right? So we should not wait until the attack happens, right? So we need to penetrate our infrastructure and we need to find the loopholes and we need to check what are the impacts of that. And then accordingly, we need to go for the remediation. That is what the main goal of penetration testing. Clear, everyone? What is penetration testing and how the pen testing work? Is that clear? See, it's an advanced level of course. So just we are going with the introduction in this. All right. So try to understand what is this penetration testings and what penetration testing is. As a clear cut, I have given a roadmap for you. So if you're really moving on to the cybersecurity field or domain, make sure follow this particular thing. So go with the courses in this level. So don't directly jump into the blue team or don't directly jump into the red team. Try to understand first what ethical hacking is and try to go in that. Okay, like ethical hacking is like your 10th standard syllabus. So in your 10th, you have all this physics, maths, biology, science, social, all these things, right? So later you move on to the inter, right? Which is plus one or plus two. In that, you look for if you're good in maths, you'll choose these MPC. If you're good in biology, you'll choose for the BIPC. If you're good in social, you'll go with CEC like that. Accordingly, also you can plan for this domain also accordingly. Like once you do the ethical hacking, you'll get an idea what are the attacks, what are the things, what are the programs we have in this. And accordingly, you can move on to the red team or you can move on to the blue team. You're getting my point? That is how I can suggest you people. Got it? Is that clear? Even before cybersecurity, if you want to do a course called, it's possible if you want to do any course, go with the network. I suggest networking. So if you're good at networking, it will be easy for you to understand these ethical hacking or these advanced courses. Okay, so try to plan accordingly, right? So a penetration testing is a security exercise where the cyber attack or expert attempts to find the loopholes in a computer systems, networks, or applications. And accordingly, they'll plan and execute that thing and they'll provide the remediation and the report writing for them. This is what the approach methodologies we call. Clear? And again, in this, we have different types of penetration testing. So we have types of penetration testing. So one is white box penetration testing. We call this as a white box testing, black box testing, and gray box testing. Do you have any idea about these white, black, and gray box testing? Anyone? No? So again, same. White box in the sense. Sorry. White box in the sense. It's kind of involving the means they'll provide some information to you to penetrate into their systems. Means they'll provide some internal information. Means they'll give the configuration plans, internal documents, and everything, and then they'll tell you to perform the testing there. Okay. So by providing this information to the tester, they can spend more time focused on the exploiting the issues. So rather than performing the host enumerations and vulnerability scanning, means they'll only give the information for them. Internal information they'll provide, like what are their IP addresses or whatever the configurations they did. All this information they'll provide to you. And as a tester, you have already the information with you, the internal information, their IP addresses, their configuration plans, everything you have. And simply you're looking for the vulnerabilities here. So no need to perform any enumeration or no need to perform any scanning here. Why? Because already you have an idea about what is the host machine, what are their IP addresses, who are the users, all this information you have in your hands. Just you need to penetrate them. You agree my point? That means as a organization person, they have access. And when it comes to the black box, the tester is provided by the bare minimum amount of information. Like company name, like they'll just give the target, that's it. You have to perform that penetration testing as an outsider. Like how outsiders will perform, attackers will perform in real time. Even they're not working in the organization also, they'll get all this information as they penetrate and they'll collect the vulnerabilities, right? The same thing you have to do. That is what the black box. So the pen tester has a limited knowledge about the systems here. Okay, when it comes to the white box, where the organization provides the pen testers with a full knowledge of the system and its configuration. Accordingly, you can perform the assessment. Okay. But here, no. Or else you can say not completely no. Limited. Limited knowledge. Here it's a full knowledge they'll have about the configuration and the system of the target, but here limited knowledge about the systems they'll provide, and you need to penetrate and you need to find them. When it comes to the gray box, it has a knowledge, some knowledge. I can say some knowledge, not limited, it's not completely or not limited one. Some knowledge it has, but not everything here. Okay, so only will give some information about the target and accordingly they'll perform. So here they'll give the internal and external information. Here they'll give only the external information. Here the both. All right. So that is what the types of penetration. White box testing is nothing but where the organization provides these testers with full knowledge of the system and its configurations, and then they can perform easily. Assessments, no need to perform this information gathering or enumerating the systems, nothing. Why? Because already they provided all that information. Just a second. Right. When it comes to the black box testing, limited knowledge means where the organizations provide a limited information or no information to the pen testers, where they have to perform this enumeration and vulnerability scanning, and they have to perform all these assessments and gather the information about the target, and then they need to perform the vulnerability assessment. Means they won't give any information to you, just they'll give the limited information like target, who is the target, and whatever the information available in public, that information they'll provide for them. And they have to collect their internal informations and get the loophole. That is what black box testing. And gray box is nothing but where the organization provides some knowledge about the system, but not everything. That is what the gray box testing is. Clear? So again, in pen testing also, three types of penetration testings will be there. Remember. Is that clear, everyone? One is black box, white box, and gray box penetration testing. So what is the benefits of this penetration testing? What you'll get? What is the benefit of performing the pen testing? What is the benefits of pen testing here? Identifying the weakness, right? That traditionally means it's where it provides some security scans might miss them. We can get that in things. Means even when you perform some vulnerability assessments, we use some vulnerability scanner tools and try to find the weakness, right? So where you can avoid and means whatever the things you missed in this vulnerability scanning, you can find those things also by penetrating that. Okay. And any other? Only finding or uncover the unknown vulnerabilities. Uncover unknown vulnerabilities. Then improve security awareness INSA. The process can raise the awareness among the employees about the security best practices here, right? And it provides the ROI, which is nothing but the cost of penetration testing is often significantly lower than the potential damage caused by the cyber attack. So whatever the impact you're getting after executing the attack on the organizations, and whatever the amount you are implementing for them can be implemented before that, right? So penetration testing is a valuable tool for the organizations of all the sizes to proactively manage their cybersecurity postures. So by simulating the cyber attacks in a controlled environment, pen testing helps identifying and addressing the vulnerabilities before they get exploited by the malicious actors. It is worth the use of penetration testing. Is that clear, everyone? Right. All right. So this is the penetration testing we have. And we have, in pen testing, as I told you, we have different types of penetration testing. So in that, we are going with the web application penetration testing. So we call WAPT, which is web application penetration testing, or pen testing, you can say, right? So what is this web application and what is this VAPT? Is that different? Is web application and VAPT is different? Actually, both are same here, but here it's looking for only the web application, but vulnerability assessment is completely for web, IoT, or anything, any IT infrastructure it can be. Okay. So here web application is only focusing on web. WAPT is only focusing on web applications like your websites or web servers, web pages. It only focus on the web applications here. VAPT is completely a vulnerability assessment and penetration testing. So VAPT is nothing but vulnerability assessment and penetration testing. This is what VAPT we call. Right. It's completely vulnerability assessment, means finding the loopholes, their impacts, their remediations, their verifications, all these things will be there. Right. Here it's focused only the web application part. It is completely on web, IoT, any kind of program, it will go with that. Right. So when it comes to the web application penetration testing, we'll go with the web application only. As a beginner, I personally suggest go with the web application pen testing first. Okay, so try to understand what is web applications. Try to understand what is this HTTP and HTTPS. So how many of you gone through with that HTTP and HTTPS? So what is the port number for HTTP? What is the port number for HTTP? Don't Google it. HTTPS. Right. So what is this get method, post method, connect method? What are all these? Put method? What are all these? And what is this, 200, 300, 400, 500, successful redirections, or client error, server error? What are these? Anyone? What are they? Any idea? We call this as a request methods. HTTP request methods, and this is the response status code. Response status codes. So whenever you do any request from your system to a server, that request is made through the URL, it takes with the get method. If it is through username and password, it takes the request with the post method and get the response in the same. And the response will be in the status code. If it is 200, means whatever the request you made is successfully executed and got that response. If it is 300, whatever the request you made, that was redirected and getting the information. If it is 403 or 404, which is nothing but the probated or not found, whatever the request you made is not found on the server. And if it is 500, means maybe it is available in server but not given for the client. That is what 400 series. 500 series instance, it is not available on the server side. You can see this payment gateway error or bad gateways like that. That is what the status codes and response methods. Sorry, request methods and response status codes. So I personally suggest go through these websites, everyone. So go with HTTP. See, it's very important to understand here. Why? Because without these things, why? Because whenever we do anything in this web application, whatever we request, that use the primary protocol called HTTP and HTTPS. Like example, you can take any browser, any web application. If you open and if you do any query, that uses this HTTPS and HTTP only. And again, you need to know their functionalities, how the things work. So what is this HTTP request? So a client, a browser send a HTTP request to the web, and a web server receives the request, and the server runs an application to the process the request, and the server returns the request in the in the response status code. Okay, so that is what the things happen here. You can see here. So whenever you request anything to the server will use the response in the response status code. So request and response scenario, it will work. So my personal suggestion, just go with this Mozilla website. So if you scroll down here, you have the HTTP headers. You can see this is the completely headers of HTTP, and you have the request methods like connect, delete, get, put, post, trace, all these things, and response status codes like 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. So see what are the most of the time you can see this 404 and 403. So 403 is nothing but the page exists, but as a client, you're not accessible for that page. That is what the meaning of that. Okay, the page exists in the server, but you're not authorized person to access that page. At that time, it will show you as a forbidden. Not found in the sense, whatever the request you made, the page is not available in the server. So like that, you have all the status codes. I'm sorry, response status codes and request methods will be there. So I personally suggest everyone, just if you want to move on to the web application in future, so just I'm giving the introduction only. I'm not going in detail about this part. It's a different course. A web application pen testing is completely a different course here. It's an advanced course in cybersecurity. Got it? So I'm giving an idea. In future, if you are moving into the web application and if you want to do a bug bounty hunting or be planning in red team, so I personally suggest try to understand the status codes and response methods. So request methods and response status codes are very important in this web application. So as you know, web application pen testing focus on identifying the vulnerabilities in web applications only. So these include the security weaknesses in the application code configuration and even underlying infrastructure that could be exploited by the attackers. And it includes many different types of methodologies. So that methodologies are like OWASP top 10. So you have to learn about these top 10 vulnerabilities. Like it contains the SQL injection, XSS, cross-site scripting, CSRF, broken authentication. Like that, you can see many different types of vulnerabilities. In the top 10 vulnerabilities will be there. Again, I'll discuss you about that OWASP top 10. But yeah, so mainly the web application focuses on website, or sorry, web applications, means focus on the web pages or web servers, what they contain, and they'll try to find the vulnerabilities in them, right? So WPT typically involves a combination of automated tools and even manual testing techniques. And remember, sir, which one I need to go with, that automation or manual? You may get this question in your mind. So most of the organization look for the manual testing sound. But because automation means, again, you're using some vulnerability scanners or penetration testing scanners, like scanning tools you'll use. So these tools won't give the accurate information. Most of the tools will give the false positive only. Means there is no attack also, it will show as the attack. You're getting my point? So, and even it impacts the production server with huge amount of traffic. So it loads the server when you perform the automation testing. So most of the organizations won't suggest you to perform the automation testing. Or they'll give the external server and you need to perform on that external server. You can't do that on directly on production servers. You can't perform the automation testing on the production server. Why? Because it impacts with the load. It continuously send the request, right? Do some plugins validations on the server, the known existing vulnerabilities on the server. So at that time, it impacts the server. It gives a huge amount of load on the server where it affects their system. So that is why they won't allow you to perform this. Only few organizations will allow you by giving some external servers or dummy servers to you to perform the automation testing. But when you go within real-time scenarios, make sure to go with the manual testing. Means not to use any tool. You need to perform that SQL injection directly on the site by implementing the payloads, not using the tools here. You're getting my point? Is that clear? So manual testing, manually inputting. Like for example, there is a website. So for example, let me take this test PHP vulnerable web. So I need to find, is there any vulnerabilities in this or not? Is there any SQL injections or not? So what I'll do, I'll go with manually like this and find, is there any login pages or input field, parameter fields. Parameter fields in the sense, like you can see the equal to one, like that, input fields. So I'll go with this part. Like for example, I'm going to give a string web, a string here, and enter. So what error I'm getting? SQL syntax error I'm getting. Means this website contains the SQL injection. Now I'll perform the SQL injection here manually by using some queries like order by one, order by two, like that. Okay, so I'll go in that way. You're getting my point? So manually, this is completely manual. Manually it takes time, definitely it takes time. Right, so I'm not getting any error. Order by two, not any error. So change. So, right. So like that manually, I need to find that. I need to take the entry. Right, or again, there is a signing page. Again, I'll try some, I'll give this true or false statements. So login incorrect. So I'll try from true or false statements here. Boolean based, I'll try on this. And If it is gives any entry for that, it will give an access form. So true or false statements will be there. So I'll try that on that part. And if it is executing true or false basis, it will give the access. So this is the union scenario. So I'll try these things on the target manually. So let me go with the footer. Payload for SQL bind, MySQL or MS SQL, you can try. So blind SQL. You can see. For us, there is a website called Payload All the Things. So for all vulnerabilities, you'll have the payloads here. You can try these payloads on the target if it is executing that, and make sure you can perform. Authentication bypassing. So you can see. You can try all these things. So you can try one by one, and you can check whether it is giving access to that or is the bypassing technique. This is one of the bypassing techniques. Yeah. So it is not executing. So like that, you can try all these things and see which one is executing on the target, and you can get that. Right. So that is what happens here in real time. This website is interesting. Now you can see it is logged in. You can see here it is saying this now. Means these are the some injection points where we need to find that is completely web application related. So that is what we need to identify by using these things. So these are there are many different methodologies. So now I have performed through manual based scenario. So manually I went to that website and I have given that payload. So apart from this, you can use some tools like Bobsuit. So you can use some Bobsuit tools. So you can download from the online. So now you can using this Bobsuit, you can try that brute forcing attacks on the target. Okay, so that is what you can do here. Right. So that is completely tool based. Tool is performing the attack on the target and getting the information. But here I went through manually. I find that login pages. I have tried this exploitation, or I have tried some blind based SQL injections here. This is completely manual. So there won't be any much load on the server part. So easily you can perform the penetration testing. So remember, most of the organization will look for the manual testing only. For my point. So like that, there is XSS, SQL injection, broken authentication, like that you have different types of attack methodologies here. Okay. So it's a combination of automated tools and manual testing techniques. So automated scanners can identify the common vulnerabilities like SQL injections, cross-site scripting. But as a penetration testing, then perform the manual testing where to exploit these vulnerabilities and access the potential impact on the application and the data it stores. That information you need to get. Got it? So what is the benefit of this web application pen testing is? By identifying and remediating the vulnerabilities in the web application, it prevents the data breaches and unauthorized access to the sensitive information and enhance the overall security postures of your web application and improve your user trust and confidence in your online services. That is what the advantage of these web application pen testing. So you should not wait until the attacks happen. Again, I'm telling this word many times. So you should not wait until the attack happens. As an organization, you need to maintain some security postures to your infrastructures, to your systems, to your networks, or to your applications here. So further, you need to have these web application pen testers where they perform and find these loopholes in the web applications and perform some assessment and perform some penetration and give the remediation techniques and reports to the client where they can defend against these attacks. That is what happens here. Clear? Is that clear, everyone? When it comes to the VAPT scenario, it is not only a web application, it performs the assessment entire IT infrastructure. It includes the operating systems, network devices, databases, and other systems where that support your web applications. Okay. So the difference between the vulnerability assessment and penetration testing is, when it comes to the vulnerability assessment, automated tools scans the systems and applications for the known vulnerabilities, and it will give the vulnerability information. That is what vulnerability assessment. And when it comes to the penetration testing, where it attempts to exploit these vulnerabilities using the techniques similar to those used by the real world attackers. Here it gives only the vulnerability. When you perform the vulnerability assessment, it gives only the vulnerabilities information by using some tools, scanning tools, get the vulnerabilities, known vulnerabilities. When it comes to the penetration testing, exploiting these vulnerabilities, seeing their impact and performing the exploitation. By performing the exploitation, they'll see the impact and they'll go with the report and they'll give the remediation also. Remediation in the sense, patch up. Solution for that particular attack. Got it? Is that clear? Is that clear, everyone? The web application pen testing and vulnerability assessment and penetration testing. Any doubts here? Is that clear about the web application pen testing? Sorry. So just see about the task, okay? So that is what the web application penetration testing. So the prerequisite for the web application pen testing is I suggest go with this functionality of web application first. So how this web application works and what is the difference of web servers and what is this websites, right? And the pages we have. So why? Because completely we are finding the vulnerabilities in these things only. We are going to find the vulnerabilities in these things only. That is what the web application pen testing is. They focus on these parts only. So to perform this penetration testing, so I suggest go with these things. If possible, try to learn some coding also. So coding is required. So without coding also, you can sustain in this domain, but it is a dependent base. When someone give that query, you need to execute that and you need to check. But for example, if you want to hack a website, first you need to understand how that website works, right? Agree for that? First, you need to understand how the website works. What, like for example, I'm injecting the code here. Previously, if you observe, I injected the code, it is not accepting. So I need to think about that, right? Why it is not taking that? What query, what input validation they are doing there? So I'll go to these inspect elements. I need to check that is there any code they have written here? So accordingly, I need to know. So will you able to understand these things? Will you be able to understand that? What they are giving the input? What is this code? Why it is not accepting my input? Why it is accepted in this website? So I tried. So randomly, I'm trying here. Randomly, I'm trying here. Right. But why I can't able to find it? Right. So if you know how the things work, means if you know how this website is functioning, what inputs they have given, what is this validation is happening there. If you know that, accordingly, you can find a known payload or you can build your own payload and you can execute that. So without knowing that knowledge, you need to follow someone's knowledge here. Like finding the payloads like this or performing some brute force on the target and getting the access. So I personally suggest if you want to be really sustained in this domain, make sure go with the coding. So you know what coding is required. So obviously for website, it is HTML, JavaScript, PHP, CSS, like these are enough for them. So websites are built with that only, right? So go with that. So I personally suggest go with that. And even go with this HTTP and HTTP. It's very important for you to understand because whatever the request you made went through this only. So you can inject these things in HTTP and HTTPS websites. So I personally suggest go with these things first to understand web application pen testing in detail. Okay. And where we perform the web application pen testing. So can we do that on live websites or not? We need to discuss. So you can't go with that live websites. Actually, your intention is good only by finding the loophole and reporting them. But some people won't accept that without their permission. So at the time, there will be some platforms to perform these activities, which is Buckroud. So I think Karthik shown you at the beginning, Buckroud or HackerOne. These are the some platforms. So HackerOne. So you can see when you go to this programs, all these things, right? So you can log into their website and you can find that. So here they'll do the websites or programs. You need to log into that. So Buckroud, if you see, there are many other platforms also. So you can see how many pen testings we have: web application, mobile network, API, IoT, cloud, social engineering pen testing. Like there are many pen testing you can see. Right. can say they submitted reports here. These are the disclosed reports. So it happened. So how much bounty they got? Some around 150K bounties they have paid for them. So using the branded hashtag features, user partnered with account manager can view videos uploaded by the private TikTok accounts if them ID is known. So that is one of the vulnerabilities they found. Like that, every vulnerabilities you can see the disclosed down and see how the attacks happen. Where are the programs, man? With the Chrome. So you can see, here are the some programs we have. So they'll keep their live websites here. So you can try to go through them. And so when, for example, there is InDrive, a Polytechnologies, like that, they'll give their programs here, like Visa. You know, this is used for credit cards or debit cards. Like that, there are many programs you can find it in them. For example, let me take this one only. So let's click on see details. Right, so this is the domain they have given, and you can see for low level vulnerability how much bounty they are paying for you, $250. For medium level of, they are paying $750 as a bounty. For high level vulnerability, $2,500 they are paying. So for critical, they are paying around $5,000 here. And what are the things, eligibility criteria they have given? So you have to must read about the descriptions carefully, and as I mentioned you, the in-scope and out-scope scenarios, right? So scope, out-of-scope in a sense, you can't try these vulnerabilities. If you try also, they won't provide any bounty for you, like cross-site scripting, cross-site request forgery or clickjacking on pages, like CSV vulnerabilities or SSL or TLS misconfiguration. They're not providing anything for that, okay? So they'll give only the in-scope scenarios where you need to perform on that particular thing only. Even in scope SS, yeah. So scope. So in these websites only you have to perform them. These are the path names where you can find them. Policies, you can see, and so we do not initiate the security investigation regarding these kind of attacks. Okay, so social engineering attacks wanted and strictly prohibited, means you can't, you should not perform the DOS and DDoS attacks. And threats and harm to the company employees should not be done. Okay. And payments made through the hacker one and invalid reports they'll look for. And you can see remote code execution vulnerability if you have. If you found any remote code execution vulnerability, they'll give you the $8,000. Okay, so you can see these are all the in-scope scenarios. These are the out-scope scenarios. So in scope, in a sense, accordingly, they'll provide the bounty for you on that particular attack. Got it? So remember that. So they'll keep the platforms here. You need to go through the platforms and you need to perform the attacks on the platforms. If you take own, you can take the live website also. But as I told you, some people will accept that activity. Some people won't accept that activity. And government sites, you can do that and you can report to NCIPC. There is a website called NCIPC, which is the website, the government website. So you can go through this. So here I have the report vulnerability disclosure program. So just go to the home, scroll down. Here you'll get the vulnerability disclosure program. Just click on that. They'll give the form. They'll give a form. Here you need to write your name, mail ID, organization, and what vulnerability you found. And is that vulnerability existed in these things? You need to check that and describe about that vulnerability. And you need to go with the date when you found and steps to reproduce that. And all these things you need to submit, and you need to download, and you need to write, and you need to submit that report to these people. Here we have mail ID. They'll provide the mail ID. In private programs also, they'll provide the mail ID, right? So Buckroad, in the sense, here itself, they'll give the report option. They'll give the report option. Can you see the submit report option here? You can click on that. You can submit the report. What, how you find that bug, in which part the bug exists, what will be the impact of that. You need to take the POC, which is nothing but the proof of concept, and you need to give the details about that particular activity. Okay, and you need to submit them. Okay, so what level of attack vector type, it will give you a score, and here you can record the demo of that particular activity. You can submit that. Okay, this is how you can submit. But when it comes to the private programs like not Buckroad or HackerOne, there itself in that portals, they'll provide the submission fields. But when it comes to the private programs, they'll give the mail IDs in their website. So you need to contact through that mail IDs or phone numbers, whatever they mention, and you need to submit that report. Okay, so that is how you can disclose them, right? So what are the attacks you can perform, in a sense? When it comes to the web applications or any kind of penetration testing, there will be a OWASP top 10. You have to learn about this OWASP top 10 actually. So OWASP top 10 is a renowned industry standard, not a website. So developed and maintained by the Open Web Application Security Project. So OWASP is nothing but here, Open Web Application Security Project. Now they're named as a Open Web Application, Open Worldwide Application Security Project, but you can say it as the Open Web Application Security Project. So it is a non-profit organization founded in 2001, and with the global of it's a goal of helping the website owners and security experts to protect their applications and applications from cyber attacks. That is what the main intention. It is a critical security awareness document where that highlights the 10 most prevalent web application security risks. So you may think like, sir, we have only 10 risks. No, there are more risky in that activities, but they go with the survey basis. Every 3 years, every 5 years, they'll do a survey and they'll find what are the top vulnerabilities, top 10 vulnerabilities that is impacting the websites or web applications. They'll bring that, they'll make a documentation on that, and they'll release in public. And accordingly, we need to penetrate that on our target websites, and we need to give the remediation for that. That is what the intention is. So these people, these OWASP top 10, will provide a documentation of the risk which happened in real world scenarios. Okay. So as a website owner or a security expert, where you need to provide a security for your web application from these cyber attacks, will implement it through this OWASP top 10. Okay. So the purpose of this OWASP top 10 is raising the awareness. Means the primary goal is to raise the awareness among the developers and security professionals about the most critical web application security risk. And prioritization means it serves a prioritization guide, helping the developers focus on addressing the most impactable vulnerabilities first. And common knowledge. By establishing a common knowledge around these top risks, the OWASP Top 10 fosters the collaboration and knowledge sharing within the web development community. Right. So the current top 10, OWASP Top 10 is 2021. So now the current OWASP Top 10 is 2021 is running. So as you know, there are different types of OWASP Top 10 till now. So there is, they started earlier in 2010, I think. 2010, we have top 10 risk. So this is 2010 scenario. So the top vulnerability we have is injection. Right. So we can see what is that injection and all these things. So injection, it may be a SQL injection. It can be a command line injection, or it may be a OS injection. It may be anything here. Okay. So injection will be there. And second, broken authentication and session management will be there. Right. So like that, you can see the different types of vulnerabilities here. These are the top 10 vulnerabilities. And again, this has happened. This will be collected based on the survey they conduct in real time attack basis. They'll conduct the real time attacks and they'll perform some surveys and gather the information. Right. Is that clear, everyone? So there will be injection, there will be a broken authentication, there will be a cross-site scripting, insecure. And the difference you can see here. So in 2010, these are the attacks we have. When it comes to the 2013, again, almost after 3 years, they brought a new OWASP Top 10 here. Instead of insecure cryptography storage, which is made to the 9, and it may change and replace with the sensitive data exposure. And failure of restricted URL access is replacing with the misuse, missing the function level access control. Like same CSRF means it changes. It changes the position. You see, when it comes to the 2013 to 17 scenario, so again, in 2017, again, they released a new OWASP Top 10. So can you see, and injection is at the top only, broken authentication as usual in second, and cross-site scripting went for the seventh position. Means it is not in third, it is not much impact in that particular years. So they made this cross-site scripting to the seventh position, and insecure direct objection is made to the eighth position. And instead of this, to combining this insecure data object and missing the thing, they made as a broken access control here. Right. So it means a change has happened here. A quite changes happened and made it to the 2017. And now currently we are using the 2021 of OWASP Top 10. So remember, in interviews, they'll ask you about the OWASP Top 10. So what are the replaces made for 2017 and 2021? Accordingly, now you need to follow with 2021. The same thing only, the same attack, but it replaces down, it went up, it came down. Now you can see last 10 years, means in 2010, injection at the top. But now in 2021, according to injection is at third position. Right, broken authentication went for the almost seventh position. And sensitive data exposure is made it to the second position as a cryptography failure, and a broken access control made it to the top. So like that, we have different attacks here. So you need to go with each and every attack in detail. Got my point? Is that clear, everyone? So these are the OWASP Top 10 where we are implementing on the websites, each and every attack. Like we'll perform the SQL injection, we'll perform the broken authentication, we'll perform the cross-site scripting, and we'll do the attacks on the target. And if we find any vulnerabilities accordingly, we'll report them to the website owners. So how we are going to report them in the sense, we need to go with the report writing. So again, report writing in the sense, you can see this is how I'll go with some report writings here. Where it is. Let me take an anchor one over there. Submit the reports, right? Yeah, disclose the report. Let me take any one of the report here. You can see. First, they'll explain you about the vulnerability, their info, and they'll give the impact by taking the screenshot, and they'll contact you. So thank you for contributing and making, and they'll say the bounty avoided is 80 to 20% split. And in additional, I'm giving the $140 will be paid to the project. Like that, they'll give that. So actually there will be a severity is low level. And what CWE is used, common vulnerability exposure will be there, CVE we called. And score will be given as a CVSS, common vulnerability scoring systems will be there. Okay. So, let me take our interns. They do actually internship. We provide the internship for them. So many of them perform their time. So let's take recently, we have one of our intern. His name is Nikhil. Let me open his drive. I'll show you how they find the bugs, what bugs they found, and how they reported. So they'll take the screenshots actually. So you can see they, when they reported that, they'll give the acknowledgement to these people. You can see. So Nikhil got the bounty. So once they visit this website, on their name, they have the bounty. Or they'll give the Hall of Fame also. You can see in this website, they found the bug and the name is given in their website. So acknowledgement to the security research. Thanks all the security research and professionals who help improve the security of our product and service through our responsible disclosure program. So these two are our interns only, Rahul and Nikhil. So they both found the bugs on their websites and they have submitted. So like this, they'll get the acknowledgement. So once they submit this acknowledgement, we'll provide the experience letter for them actually by finding these things. So there are some report writing scenarios also. Okay. So you need to learn about the report writing. So sample report. So you can see what are the cross-site scripting, what is insecurity serialization, insufficient login. You'll get all this information. But sample, I'll go in this hacker one only. Or hacker one, we have that. So when you go with the submit report, you need to make a documentation actually. So you can see, you need to give what is asset, what is asset type, it is that a domain or is that a application or is that a particular website, you need to give that here. Okay, once you need to give your target and report the template. If you have any template, you can report the template here. And what weaknesses, if is that access control or spoofing or whatever the attacks you have, you can mention that attack. If it is not available, you can type that attack here. Okay, you can give the CWE also. If it is a cryptography issue, you can mention the cryptography issue. If it is a OAPS top 10 based, you can mention them. All these attacks they have provided here. Accordingly, you can mention that OAPS top 10 attack, what you perform, and submit a report without CVRT. Or if you want to submit a report with CVRT also, you can go with that. So with CVRT in the sense, you need to mention that what is attack vector. Is that locally happen, you perform that attack within your network, or physically you take the access of the device and you perform the attack, or connected to the network you perform the attack. What exactly it is, you need to select that. An attack complexity is low or high. If it is high, go with high. And privilege required, is that privilege required to perform that attack? None. If go with none, if obviously it requires in the sense, go with high. And user interaction is required, no. Scope unchanged or changed means is there any data altering or is the data only getting for them that we need to check, unchecked on, unchanged only. Confidentiality, only the data is accessible by that particular user or anyone can access that. None, or I can go with high. Are you able to tamper the data? Yes. Are you able to make this server down or make that server unavailability? You can make it. So finally, it will give a score for you accordingly. It will generate the score. So that we called as a CVSS, Common Vulnerability Scoring System 3.01 we are using. Or manually, you can give that score. So like high, critical, or whatever, you can give that, and you can give the title of that particular thing. And you need to go with the description, complete description you need to write here. What the attack, in which part the attack is happened, what payload you use, how it is injecting, all that you need to describe that. And if you make a POC, you can submit that POC proof of concept here, or you can take the screenshot and you can drop the screenshots of that file also. Right. And then you can go with your steps, all these things they'll ask you. And they'll tell you to submit to the report. Okay. And submit that report. Same, this is a craft, or you can take this report as your thing. You can go with your own way. If it is a private thing, like just describe, description will be there, summary and steps to reproduce and add your steps and submitting references or whatever the POCs here, you can submit them. So this is a general report. So these are the OWASP top 10. So now you have to go through these 2021 OWASP top 10. Okay. So now they change it to 2021 from the survey basis. Got it? So that is what the OWASP top 10. So OWASP top 10 is a common, sorry, open web application security project. So it's a non-profit organization where they'll give an idea about these attacks to the penetration testers or security analyst people or security professionals to secure their websites in real-time based attacks. From real-time based attacks, they want to secure their websites. They have to follow these attacks. So don't think like only 10 attacks are there. Means they take this as a priority. Okay. Is that clear? All right. So I'll share the document for you. So you can just go through the document. So I made a document on this. So what are the required necessary things for the web application pen testing? You can go through that. So if in future, if you have any programs, we'll go with the advanced level. We'll see about the web applications also. So I mentioned about the web applications, what is the importance of web application pen testing, the approach methodologies, and the status codes. You need to learn the methods you need to go, and OWASP top 10 according to 2021 scenario I mentioned, and some of the attacks like SQL injection, their types of SQL, and some of the tools where you can perform the web application. All right. So this is all about the a web application introduction. Clear, everyone? So if you want to perform the web application penetration testing, you should be good at OWASP top 10. These OWASP top 10, you have to go with each and every vulnerability, and you need to understand the things, how the things work in real time. You need to implement that on the real-time websites and whether that is applicable on real-time website and it is giving the information, then you need to report that to the concerned person. And make sure take the permission, get the approach, and then only perform the penetration testing. Without the approaching them, don't do that activity. If you want to really perform them, so I personally suggest go with this Buckcrowd, HackerOne, or even you have this many open platforms. Yeah, so I'll give that open platforms. So how many different platforms like CNAPP, Integrity, or Cobalt.io, Buckcrowd, HackerOne, like that. You have, these are all the bug bounty platforms only. So bug bounty platforms in the sense they'll give the open platforms for you and they'll give the programs and you need to penetrate them and find the bugs and submit them and they'll give the bounty for you. So it depends on your bug criticality, they'll pay the bounty. Some people will give only Hall of Fame. Like you can see Nikhil got only the Hall of Fame as they have given a thanks thing on their website itself, or else they'll send some hoodies to you. So as a Hall of Fame. And some people will pay bounty. Especially for government sites, then you just an acknowledgement, that's it. Thanks for securing our website. That's it. You don't get bounties there. So it depends. It depends on the criticality of that particular thing. You can see government sites, they didn't went down. CIPC. No, they went for the private programs only, most of them. All right, so this is a brief introduction to the web application pen testing. So if you're really interested on this part, look into further. So these are all the things. This is just an introduction for you about this penetration testing and what is this web application pen testing and what is the vulnerability assessment and penetration testing and what are the programs we have in this pen testing. In that, one of the program we choose is web application pen testing. And again, these web application pen testing methodologies are OWASP top 10. So you guys have to focus on this OWASP top 10. Got it? Is that clear, everyone? So this is all about our program here. So do you have any doubts related to the topics which we covered till now? So this is the last session actually. So I thought we'll end up here for web application. So it's completely next level, of course it will be. So let me know, do you have any doubts related to this program? Whatever the topic we went through. So whatever the topics we covered till now, not only this particular topic I'm asking about, like whatever the topics we covered till now. Like beginning from networking, ethical hacking, until web application. Do you have any doubts? So consider this is the last session. So make sure, just confirm with that. Do you have any doubts? And you want me to recall any topic, just let me know. And just let me know like how you felt about this program. Have you learned anything from this program? Just let me know. What do you guys think? Have you gained any knowledge from this program? Yes. I'm asking you guys only, like I need some response from your end, guys. Everyone, just pay attention here. Have you learned anything from this program that you want me to do any changes? Just I need your suggestions and I need your feedback, which helps a lot by giving your feedback, but because in future it may help other students. Yeah, this is the last session. Just I'm ending with the introduction of web application. So it's an advanced courses again. So I'm just giving an idea about actually cryptography is the last program I thought. So I'm giving an idea about the web application and I'm leaving. How you guys felt? Just let me know. I need your feedback, guys. And do you have any queries you can ask me? We have 30 minutes more, you can ask me. Will there not be any more classes, sir? No, it will be on project basis. And you'll have the test on these topics. I didn't get you, ma'am. In virtual box, how can hold virtual machines? How can hold virtual machines? I didn't get that. In virtual box, it was very helpful. Way of explaining things. Yeah, thank you. The topics what we covered is so we went through. Yeah, I'll recall the things whatever I covered for you guys. So beginning from networking. So we started with network fundamentals, right? So in that, I covered about the internet, how internet works. And we discussed about the history of the internet and all those things. And next we move on to the networking. And in that we discussed about the computer networks. And types like LAN, WAN, MAN, about. And we discussed about the network topologies. And we discussed about the OSI model and TCP IP model. And we discussed about the network addresses. I think you guys have a document on this in your Telegram group. I have shared complete networking fundamental document. I hope you guys found that. Logical address and physical address we discussed. And we discussed about the OS architectures, like about the kernels. And we went for the Linux setup, which is nothing but the hypervisors we discussed. We discussed about the hypervisors, which is nothing but we set up the Linux machine, which is Kali. So this is what we discussed in network fundamentals, right? So these are the topics which I have covered in network fundamentals. And next I have moved on to the ethical hacking part. So in ethical hacking, we started with the introduction. So introduction to ethical hacking, like what is cybersecurity? And in that we discussed about the cyber kill chains, MITRE attack, information security, MITRE attack. What is the difference between the hacking and ethical hacking? What is cyber threat intelligence analyst? And TTPs, tactic, techniques, and procedures. And difference between the information securities and cyber securities. Cyber laws. Is that the cyber laws? Right. So information security standards also we discussed as an introduction. And after that, we went for the module two, which is reconnaissance or footprinting. And then we moved on to the scanning, information gathering, and we discussed about the enumeration, like a password cracking scenarios. Then we went to the system hacking. And we discussed about the malwares, threats, what is malwares, malware analysis. And we discussed about the DOS and DDoS attacks. And we discussed about the sniffing. These are all the modules we discussed. And we discussed about the social engineering. And what we discussed. Firewalls, IDS and IPS, about honeypots, and then we'll move on to the wireless hacking, and we discussed about the cryptography, and today just given the introduction to penetration testing. So in that we discussed about the what is penetration testing, what is vulnerability assessment and penetration testing, and types of pen testings. And we discussed about the web application pen testing and OAPS top 10. Right. So approaches. Just I have given approach methodologies for you. So these are the topics which we covered in this program. And do you have any doubts related to that? Let me know. Almost I have given some 15 to, I think I'll consider as a 15 tasks for you. Okay, given more tasks, almost 20 sessions, 25 sessions we done. So almost we have given some, every session you have a task actually, that is what assignment we call. So I'll consider only 15 assignment, minimum 15 assignments actually you have to submit. Okay. So I'm not going with 25 assignments. Maybe you miss one or two assignments. So on that basis, I'm making it to the 15 assignments you have to complete. Accordingly, you'll get the score and you'll get the certification, remember. So I'll manage in that basis. So actually, I have to go with all these 23 to 25 assignments actually, if you take every session you have an assignment. But I'm considering at least minimum 15 assignments you have to do. And you have to submit that in the drive and you have to share that drive link in the form. Remember, if no one, if it is less than 15, you'll get a less score or accordingly the score will be given for you. So make sure, and we are checking whether you're copying or not, everything will be reviewed here. Some people have shared someone's document here. So go through that, everyone. As you know, you're getting the certification based on the assignments and this grand test only. So project is not that much mandatory here. So remember, is that clear, everyone? So focus on the assignments and the grand test. Can you have the grand test on this part also? And I have given questions from the web pen testing also. And whatever the topics we covered, I have given the questions from that. And make sure about the cryptography and all these things. Go through that. You'll get the questions from that only. All the tasks that mentioned by you, sir, I'm having the tasks from 15th session, I think. I didn't note it down previously. If anyone noted down, you can get that from the recording sessions. You have the recording sessions, right? The sessions I used to mention. I have from 14th session. So if you have a recording session, you'll get it that. So I have from 14th session. Second, I'll try to share that. All right, so sir, how can we add a Wi-Fi router in virtual machine? In virtual machine, I'm sure you can go in this. Like, is there a VMware or virtual box? Virtual box, right? Okay. So in virtual box, when you connect any adapter, let me connect my adapter. Sir, how to submit the project? See, again, the project work is completely handled by the team. They will explain you. They'll contact and they'll explain. I'll inform them how to submit the project abstract. So when you connect the virtual box machine, so once you turn on that machine, I'll show you. So footprinting is nothing but here the information gathering. So the information gathering will be in two types. One is passive based and one is active based scenario. So passive is nothing but we are gathering the information, whatever available in the public platforms. So and I have given a document on that part also, like what are the DNS enumeration we performed, extracting the employee details or extracting the emails or performing some email analysis, gathering the web technologies information or catchy information gathering, or you can go with the Multigo tool also. So where to perform the passive information gathering. And when it comes to the active information gathering, that is what we did in scanning phase, which is Nmap. So if you remember the Nmap concept, that is completely active information gathering scenario. Right. So there are many different sources, open sources or OSINT sources you have where to gather the information about your target. So depends on the target here completely. Okay, so just I suggest just go through the document or the recording session what you have. Sujit. Okay. MITRE ATT&CK is nothing but here. It's a framework. Again, it's a cybersecurity framework that will help you to understand the real world observation of the cyber attacks. Means when you perform this information gathering, what information you'll get and how will you mitigate and how will you detect that attack? That information you'll get it here. So if you see here, so based on the 14 tactics will be there. So there will be MITRE ATT&CK website. If you visit this website, so here itself, they have mentioned you about what exactly the MITRE ATT&CK. So ATT&CK is nothing but here, advisories, tactic, technique, and common knowledge. So it is globally accessible knowledge based on the advisories, tactics, and techniques based on the real world observations. Okay. And if you take the tactics, you can see these are all the tactics only coming from reconnaissance, resource development, all this, almost 14 tactics, you can find it here. Okay. So if you take any of the tactic, for example, let me take the tactic as a reconnaissance. In that, we are using a technique called active scanning. You know, active scanning. Directly, we are sending the packets. In response, we are getting the information about the target, like what services they are running, what operating systems they are running, what are all these things, you'll get that. So that information they'll provide you here. And they'll give the mitigation of that particular tactic. And even they'll give the detection of that particular tactic. Means how you can detect and how you can mitigate that particular attack or tactic, they'll provide you based on the real world observation. When it comes to the cyber kill chain, it is completely on the real-time scenarios here. Like what you can say, real-time, like according to the Lockheed Martin point of view. It's not real-time. It is according to the Lockheed Martin point of view. The attacks might occur in 7 different stages. That's what we discussed in cyber kill chain. But this MITRE ATT&CK is real-world observation scenario. Okay. So you can follow all these 7 tactics, and they have the matrices also. You can implement this framework for the enterprise-based, mobile-based, and ICS, industrial control systems also. Accordingly, you have the tactics here. Okay. So once you open the machine, I think someone asked about this. How is that? You can see once you connect that, means once turn on your machine and run that operating system, and after running the operating system, just plug your adapter and make sure here you can see the input device, right? Or devices. Can you see the devices here in virtual box? In that, you can see the network. So in network, you can connect your adapter. So connect the adapter. So it will connect that adapter. Or else you can go to the USB also. In USB, how can you see here? It is showing my adapter. So not in network, go with the USB. Here it will show you the adapter. Just click that adapter. Now it will connect that adapter to this machine. Okay. In that way, you can connect. For VMware, directly it will show you at the beginning when you connect. It will show you like you want to connect this USB to the primary OS or VMware. Once you select the VMware to which operating system you want to connect, it will show you like that in VMware basis. Okay. All right. Is there anyone from Black Box? Akila or anyone? Is there anyone from Black Box? All right. So yeah, if you have any doubts, yeah, let me know. We'll discuss on that part. Or else, yeah, thank you everyone. Thank you for attending this session. It's a great meeting you all. Soon we'll try to meet again. I hope you learned something from this program. I have shared in chat. I have shared to the Gayatri. Sorry. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, thank you, everyone. Thank you. I'm not having 25 from 14 session I'm having. I'm sharing that. So you can check that in the chat. Almost from 14 session to 25 sessions, you have the task. Remaining, if possible, go through these recording sessions where you can find from there. Is that clear, everyone? Any doubts? So this will be our last session. Thank you guys. So thank you everyone. So send the session related documents. Yeah, I have already submitted to the team. They'll upload and they'll inform you. Maybe you'll get to your Gmail. Check that. So when to submit all the tasks? Yeah, we'll give the time. We'll update you that. We'll update that in the Telegram group. Yeah, thanks. Thank you. Yeah, thank you guys. Try to submit the drive link in that form channel. I have given a form, right? So try to share that in the form. All right. So hope everyone done, right? So no doubts, right? All right then. Yeah. Thanks for joining, guys. Yeah, thanks for that. That will be updated in your Telegram group. They'll update you like when to submit all the tasks. If possible, if you're done with that, submit them. Okay. Yeah, thank you.